I hope you like it. I get this fucking strap sound. Come on.
Last Friday night she went and bought some cocaine. Saturday she went and bought some more. And on Sunday night she was shacked up at the crack house. She was sucking anything she could score. And on Monday night I took her down some pictures of me and her back on our wedding day. And on Tuesday night I stopped by with the babies, and it breaks my heart to see her this way. She is a white trash crack whore who sometimes works streets near Fifth Vine. She is a white trash crack whore. She didn't act this way when she was mine. She's got this pimp named Snake that gives her beatings. Hell, he leaves her bruised and battered on the floor. Looks like my simple country girl's gone crazy. She's all broke out and need on Marshall's oars. She is a white trash crack whore who sometimes works streets near Fifth Vine. She is a white trash crack whore. She didn't act this way when she was mine. No, she didn't. She called on Sunday night. She said, Wes, I love you. I told her it's probably best if she'd stay gone. But on Monday night she OD'd in the bathroom, and the police say she died in that snake's arms. Well, she was a white trash crack whore. She used to work the streets near Fifth and Vine. She was a white trash crack whore. And I thank the Lord every day that bitch ain't mine.
That's how tonight's gonna go. For the most part. So, that song was written by badass Billy Gang. If you ain't heard of Billy Gang, go look him up. He's in the same rankings as Billy Don Burns and all of them. Speaking of Billy Don Burns, I got this song I'm about to record in Indiana, over in Bright, Indiana.
Yeah.
And it's about a lonesome train. This song's called The Lonesome 77203. It was written by Billy Don Burns.
Well, I'm the train bound to nowhere, but I don't tire. I don't leave. Ain't nobody waiting on me. They call me the Lonesome 77203. With a little child, yeah. Well, mama, mama, look at your mom at what I see. The old outlaw train they call Lonesome. Call me in Lonesome 77203. Well, I don't stop that train for no one, and I don't share my misery. Don't sell no fares, I don't take all riders, not on the Lonesome 77203. Well, that bastard sheriff, he said the train's on something. Somebody said, sheriff, what the hell you reckon it be? He's all tongue tongue like old Hank Williams, riding the Lonesome 77203. Well, I'm the train, not bound nowhere. I don't tie, I don't bleed. Ain't nobody waiting on me. They call me the Lonesome 77203.
Let's see. I got this new one that I wrote. And it's really fucking new. We're gonna make t-shirts off of it. I'm blind as shit, so I might get the lyrics wrong. This song's called Play Something Sad, I just wrote it. Do you play for tips? I'll drop 20 right now. If you'll play some Keith Whitley and possibly make me break down, play Don't Close Your Eyes, make me think of her. Whiskey and her. Won't you play something sad? Let's Conway or old Charlie Pride make it hurt bad. Like it cut me down, way down inside. Long with the slow country songs all I have. Won't you play something sad? If you take requests, don't play nothing fast. Jukebox, it won't help her memory last. Play the grand tour, hit me right in the vein. There ain't nothing like the beautiful sound of a slow winding steed. To play something sad, play some Merle Haggard or Willie this time, make it hurt bad, so bad, like a club in and way down inside. Just make it last long with a slow country songs all I have. Won't you play something sad? Basically because I had a bunch of people coming up at these shows and they're like, hey, can you play something more upbeat? Or play me a love song, or write me a love song. You asked me to write you a love song. I tried to write a love song and it turned into, I love you so much, why the fuck did you cheat on me? Really quick, like the first chorus, it turned into that. So, we're still learning how to get past that part. Play y'all one that you probably know that I wrote. I wrote this about my dad, and I got to play it for him in person the second time ever at the Everglades Seafood Festival I just got back from. We got to play with folks like Ryan Bingham from Yellowstone. Way Jennings was there. And I played Hank Forrest's whole set with him. And it was pretty cool. We get to do it again, June 16th? Hey. Something like that. No, this year. At that Moonshine Festival in Beattiesville. Cindy. And the very next day, we got Brother Ward Davis playing there.
We love Ward.
I already bought my tickets like 3 weeks ago, and I'm sleeping in their basement that night. They got a hammock. They said it may or may not be haunted. But fuck it, we'll find out. And then I'm playing there the very next day with Jason Evans and Jared Hill. So a whole weekend of fuckery going on in Indianapolis. Play y'all one of my favorite Johnny Paycheck songs. How many Johnny Paycheck fans we got out there? I got to play this song on Billy Dog Burns' guitar first time I ever met him. Second time I ever met him. The first time we don't need to talk about over a microphone. But it was wild. But this is the song I got to play on his guitar that Paycheck used to borrow from him from time to time. Time in my life where I felt as long as I do not. Well, I feel like I could lay down and get up no more, and it's the damnedest feeling I've ever felt it before. Say, and I only wish this feeling would just go away. And I guess it's 'cause the truth is the hardest thing I've ever faced. 'Cause you can't change the truth in the slightest way. I've tried. So I asked myself, I said, Wesley, where do you go from here? Like a fool, I turned around and I looked in the mirror. And there call
gives me a hope. The whiskey is settled in hand, and with any luck, I'll be good and drunk by then.
See him.
Do you see where he's playing in Hayes?
Yeah. Yeah,
I said he's at war with this police station.
I sent my submission in for the name on that
new sheriff
in town, yeah. You want me to? That's so slow. I'm gonna play y'all Keith Whitley song and then I'm gonna play y'all something I wrote. Jesse Keith just did a cut on this song. And for anybody that's not doing nothing, the weekend of June 17th, we got a show going on. It'll be me on Thursday with, I don't know who I'm playing with on Thursday, but Friday is Josh Bogart and Jesse Keith Whitley, and then Saturday will be Struggle Jennings, Cletus T. Judd, and Jelly Roll. I can't remember the name of the band. I'll figure it out when they make the flyer. But Jesse did a cut on this song, and Keith did a demo cut on it. You know, it's probably my favorite song he did. It's called I Went Crazy for a While.
She asked me how I've been since you're leaving me. Old friend, thanks for your concern. Say you haven't seen me for some time now. And if I've been gone, when did I return? Well, I stayed in the same place you left me. Close to the phone, just in case she died. But it seems that I recall that I went somewhere. Yeah, I went crazy for a while. And I went out of my mind so I wouldn't have to see. Face reality. But I stared at her picture for so long. I saw her smile. Yeah, I went crazy for a while. Doing time here inside her memory. And I need her like a prisoner needs a file. I'd like to tell you more, but I forgot the rest. Did I mention I went crazy for a while? So I went out of my mind so I wouldn't have to see the fool in the mirror, the face. face reality. So I stared at her picture for so long. I saw her smile. Hell yeah, I went crazy for a while. She asked me how I've been since her leaving me. Hello, friend, thanks for your concern.
This next song's about every fucked up little shitty roach motel I've ever partied my ass off in. Grouped them all in one song. Baby, you know the drill? Second verse, just plug your ears. Or throw me the bird. She'll still like me later, I think. This song's called Some Rundown Motel. It really is, ain't it? That's just how I get off. After the show, Brie'll be tagging along, I think. Some rundown motel becomes our second home. Alright, baby, you know what to do. Well, old lady love, she might never find me. Some crack horse shacked up until dawn. Whoops. Some rundown motel becomes our second home. Well, an old rolling stone, it don't gather no moss. Hitting the highway, that's just how I get on. After the show, three will be tagging along. Crack horse, that is. Some rundown motel becomes our second home. I don't have a crack whore obsession anymore, but.
Hey, Ryan's talking about, you know, finding that sugar monster.
Get right on it. We'll put it in the ads.
Army song?
Yeah. So my,
he recommended Travelin Soldier from the Dixie Chicks.
From the Dixie Chicks? I'm doing a Dixie Chicks song, y'all.
Only because he's getting deployed tomorrow.
My girlfriend's cousin Gregory is getting deployed tomorrow to Germany, and he's on the phone right now, and I'm gonna play him this song. It's a good thing I played guitar for my sister for years before I started singing.
Two days past 18, was waiting for the bus. His army greens sat down at a booth, a cafe there, and he gave his order to a girl. The bow in her hair, she's a little shy, so she gives him a smile. Said, would you mind sitting down for a while and talking to me? Feeling a little home. Set him off in an hour, and I know where we can go. So they went down and they sat on the pier. Said, I bet you got a boyfriend, but I don't care. I got no one to send a letter to. Would you would you mind if I sent one back here to you? Soldier's coming home. So the letters came from an army camp, California, Vietnam, and he told her of his heart. Might be loving all the things he was so scared of. Said when it's getting kind of rough over here, thinking that day sitting down at the pier, and I close my eyes, see your pretty smile. Says the soldier's coming home. Said, folks, won't you bow your heads for a list of low Vietnam dead? Crying all alone under the stands, it's a big old player in the marching band, one named Red, nobody really cared. But a pretty little girl with a bow. Travelin soldier, our love will never end. Waiting for the soldier to come back again. Never hope to be alone when the letter says the soldier's coming home.
Got one more? All right. So I'm not going to play the single I got coming out because it's a duet, and I can't sing her parts. I wrote the song, I can't sing her parts, no. So I'm going to play you guys a song written by probably my favorite songwriter outside of Blaze Foley and Townes Van Zandt. Guy's a little more modern, but his name's Casey Beathard. He wrote the song, and it was on a really early Eric Church album. But it's called Where She Told Me to Go. It ain't doing a bit of good.
this last chance for gas neighborhood. Life's looking for freedom. Life's looking for a good time. Life's looking for a little space. A little place that was mine, all mine. Now it's going with my chain of heart. I wanted no part of forever. I was looking for a blessing. And I said, darling, it's all for the better. Hell, what do you know? I think I wound up where she told me to go. Places, man, I broke down here. Shade Tree Mechanic, he told me, son, can't get no parts for this here making here. Don't worry, boy, I'll get it done. This godforsaken place is at least 2 weeks from everywhere. Life's looking for freedom. Life's looking for a good time. Life's looking for a little space, a little place, have some peace of mind. Life's going with my change of heart. I wanted no part of forever. I was looking for. I said, baby, it's all for the better. Hell, what do you know? I think I wound up where she told me to go. Hell, this place ain't on no map. How sad I know it's everywhere and she ain't had. She told me to go. Where she told me to go.
My name is Wes Shipp. I got shirts out of the car. Micah Howard's about to come up, y'all. Stay tuned.